So what we have here is a two strategies, one plain question. Good morning. Happy Wednesday. I have NeuroCoffee in hand and it is perfect. Wednesdays are crunch time. We gotta cook through this, but a quick reminder, we got the Coffee and Coaches Conference call tomorrow morning, 6 a.m. Eastern. Please join us. The link will be on my professional Facebook page, which is at Bill Hartman PT, I believe. And so please join us. They've been great calls. If you can't make the call, hey, why not throw up a question here on the Instagram or on the YouTubes if that's where you're watching this. Speaking of YouTube, I had a question that came through YouTube from David, and he says, Bill, with a big exclamation point. So apparently he's very excited to send me a message, and I appreciate that. He goes, I'm a big fan of your videos on YouTube. Well, there you go. That's why you got the exclamation point. Based off your explanation with this knee pain, it seems that limitations are internal rotation. We should try to restore femoral tibial internal rotation through the foot and pronation to fall into dorsiflexion rather than plantar flexion in the mid-propulsive phase. I even find that sometimes abdominal work on the same side of knee pain along with posterior thorax expansion will help with the knee pain as well. I'd appreciate your feedback. Thanks. David, this is really good. So David is watching the a knee pain video that's on YouTube. There's a reference right there. And so what we want to talk about here is the two strategies, one plain concept. And so the reason that we want to do this is because what we have to recognize is that we have only two strategies available to us. We can either expand or we can compress, and each one of those is represented in the human body by internal and external rotation. And so all movements are based off of those two rotations, which fall into the transverse plane. So again, two strategies, one plane. So when I put together the archetypes as the wides and the narrows, what I did is I was constructing the archetypes to represent the two extremes. So one is this massive compressor, one is this massive expander. And so that's why they have these biases towards certain strategies. The thing that you want to recognize, regardless of the archetype, is that as we apply forces into the ground, we are superimposing internal rotation on top of external rotation. And so one of the limitations that I think most people have because of the way that they've been educated and because of the way the information is presented is that there's certain areas of your body that internally and externally rotate, and there's certain areas that don't, or they do the opposing. And the thing we want to recognize is that internal and external rotation is systemic. So it's the entire system that is moving into and out of internal and external rotation. It's supported by the breathing mechanism as we internally and externally rotate. And so when we run into compensatory strategies or other limitations that are superimposed upon us, that's where we might have problems that arise, because now we have to strategize how to maintain our two strategies under some certain circumstance or limitation or some other context. And so again, if we want to look at this thing as how we distribute these things, so we can look at the foot, and David mentioned this, is that, okay, so what I want to be able to do to alleviate the pressure on the knee is I need to be able to acquire this middle propulsive strategy where this arch goes down and I get the tibial internal rotation. If I can't do that, so if I have an orientation or I have a strategy that I have to use where I'm trying to maintain a supinated foot, I have just eliminated my ability to distribute internal rotation throughout the system, and now I might get a focal load. So maybe that shows up as a knee compensatory strategy, and now I have too much internal rotation force that's applied locally, and then that might result in a pain experience. So structure and strategy are going to help us determine how we're going to produce these forces. And once again, if we don't distribute them well, we're going to find a way. You're going to find a way to internally rotate. And so what I want you to start to recognize is that anytime you use the words extension, adduction, or internal rotation, we're talking about the exact same thing. This is a force that goes into the ground. So we will find a way to apply force into the ground. So now let's take this up to the pelvis for a second. So let's just say that I have some form of compressive compensatory strategy that is gonna take away some of my internal rotation via orientation, compression, etc. What I might see is somebody anteriorly orienting their pelvis forward. This is another attempt to get force into the ground. So this is internal rotation. That again might limit my ability to distribute. So now maybe somebody walks in with back pain. So the solutions for us as practitioners and coaches, when we have limitations in movement, when we have situations where people might be coming to us with pain experiences, is we have to determine what strategies that they are using. And then as we alleviate that and we teach them how to redistribute these forces throughout the system, this is the solution in many, many cases. Not every case. Sometimes we have constraints that have changed. Sometimes we have neurologic influences that will supersede the biomechanical aspect of this. But in many, many cases, we've just failed to distribute these forces. And so I would encourage you, number one, as a solution, is learn how to measure reliably. You have to create a representation of what this person is bringing to you in three dimensions, preferably four dimensions, because we do have a time constraint here that under many cases. Secondly, you need to recapture external rotation. So external rotation is a very, very broad field. Internal rotation is superimposed upon it. If I have limitations in the expansive capability, which means I've limited ER, I've immediately limited my IR capabilities, and now I have a limited capacity to distribute force and load throughout the system. Okay, once I recapture the external rotation, that's the time to start to superimpose internal rotation upon it in a distributed manner, if my goal is to increase adaptability. When we're talking about performance, when we're talking about taking somebody into the weight room, or we're training them to produce speed and force and power, we may intentionally restrict the adaptability to create these high levels of performance, because higher force output speed demands that we have limitations in movement. So we might have to do that intentionally, but we monitor them over time, key performance indicators, to make sure that we don't end up with vocal pressures, potential destructions, et cetera, et cetera. If we just do the best we can, injuries are gonna happen no matter what. So David, thank you. I love talking about the two strategies, one plane concept. It's so simple, but it needs to be understood so it can be applied effectively, so we can provide solutions to our patients and our clients. Everybody have a fabulous Wednesday. Coffee and Coaches Conference call 6 a.m. tomorrow. I will see you guys there. Have a great day.